Hi, and welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So continuing with the story of Gideon, we read that the Midianites were camped just below them in the valley below. And it was a reminder to us that our position needs to be in the middle.
Right.
That we can't rise above God because God should always be above us.
Yes.
But the Bible clearly says that the enemy is under our feet.
Yes, he is.
So we should not give him any other place.
Right.
He should always be below us. Yeah. And we need to make sure that we keep him there.
Yeah.
There were two words I brought out that would be so easily passed by us just reading the scripture. Mm. And it said that night. And I shared quite a lot on that on Sunday. I've kind of had thoughts about that since as well. Because there was something about that night. And there's something about our nights. Mm-hmm. And there are definite nights when we need to understand that they're significant with that particular night. Mm-hmm. But also, it was just the fact that it reminded me of the fact that the enemy is most vulnerable in our night seasons. We actually think it's the other way around.
Mm.
But actually the enemy is vulnerable in our night seasons. And there's a reason for that, you know, that because the enemy is watching us in our night seasons, but God wants us to watch the enemy in our night seasons.
Yes. Yeah, I think, and we all have night seasons, don't we? There's times when, you know, it is dark and it is, you know, a difficult time in our life, and it would seem as if God is a long, long way away.
Right.
And we feel very alone and we feel very vulnerable.
Right.
And it is actually often when we feel as if we're far away from God that we're actually the closest that we've ever been.
Well, we have to be, don't we?
Exactly.
Because we've got nothing else to draw on.
Yeah.
It's often in the night seasons when we've tried everything else.
You just grasp.
And we come back to God.
Yeah.
And so the enemy's hoping we don't get that.
That's right.
He hopes we won't get through it.
That's right. But yeah, that's, and often we have to be brought to that place, don't we?
Right.
And it's not as if God takes away everything in order that we get to that place, although he might. But he will use that situation, and he is just longing for us to cry out for him.
Right.
Because you just turn around and there he is.
And we are better than we think in those nights.
We're stronger than we think.
Right.
We feel weak and vulnerable, but actually the power that is within us is as strong as it's ever going to be.
Right.
And we are so much stronger than we think.
We really know, we find out something about ourselves in night seasons.
We might surprise ourselves.
We really find out how strong our faith truly is.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it is only in the night seasons that really gets tested.
Yes.
And, you know, God wants us to check in and check out on what the enemy's being freaked out over.
Yeah.
Because our getting through the night seasons freaks the enemy out.
Yeah.
I mean, he is just hoping we do not get through that.
That's right.
But when we do, we need to listen in to what's freaking the enemy out.
It's be encouraging.
Yeah.
We'll bounce back even stronger.
We'll share a little bit more on that tomorrow.
Okay.
Whatever you're doing, have a great day.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.